movie.
And welcome to In Retrospection, the show where we review the retro today. I am Joshua Caleb, and joining me today, as always, is Dustin Schmidt.
Hey Joshua, how are you doing today?
Pretty good. Things are a little crazy, searching for jobs, whatnot.
Well, I wish you luck.
Yeah. So, since I've been job hunting, I haven't had a lot of time to prepare and get ready for the show. So, rather than just not do an episode completely, I thought we would incorporate a little bit of my mini-series I've been doing on YouTube, my random retro bonus round, into In Retrospection. Just do a show entirely composed of random retro games.
Sounds like a plan to me.
Yeah, so it should be interesting. And I'm doing the Game Boy and Game Boy Color for our system, since we haven't really covered a lot of portable games, really. So
yeah, this should be interesting.
Give the Game Boy some love. Okay, so first off, we need a random letter and or number. Apparently there are quite a few games that have numbers in the title. So, random letter or number?
Let's see. Let's go with 8.
Is there an 8 in... you know, there may not be an 8.
Oh,
that may be one of the few numbers that doesn't start...
Okay.
Oh, wait, there is
an
8.
How about
we
go with a J?
Okay, otherwise I did find 1-8.
Oh, okay. Go for it.
It's the only one, so...
Cool.
Total random here. This does not look like a game.
that's a very interesting game we have here.
Yeah, okay. 8 in one color.
This is like one of those old calculator games.
Yeah, it does sort of look like a would be. Okay. I did something. What is it doing? Okay. I think we can call this game a fail.
Yeah, 8 is a horrible game.
Yeah, 8 and 1, whatever that is, horrible game.
Yep, horrible. Don't recommend it.
Okay, what was the other letter you said?
J.
Okay, we'll go J. Oh, lots of J's. Okay, how about a number?
J11.
Okay. J League Supporter Soccer, which would be a Japanese game.
Oh.
Okay, what if we skip down? We'll skip down a bit. I don't want to try and translate Japanese, especially since I don't know it. Okay,
yeah,
we'll skip down.
I'm not very good at it either, unfortunately.
We got a right below here. We got a James Bond something.
Oh, hey, sounds good.
Let's try some Bond. Okay.
Music is rocking.
Yeah, the 8-bit Bond music is surprisingly good.
Yeah. It'd be a cool ringtone.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Start a new game.
I wonder which movie this was based off of, or if it was just like Bond in general.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
A lot of times it seems like the games are based off of one particular movie.
Yeah, I'm not that familiar with the Bond movies to know. Who's Decoder?
So oh, I would assume one of these,
either this person or somebody else, would have a decoder.
That is some horrible text. That typeface. Bono, now that you have arrived in China, we can provide you with more details on your mission.
I'm Bond.
MI6 received a tip from an operative that a large arms ring is in operation. Plans detailing the whereabouts of this ring are said to be kept in China. Commandeer them and return to London as soon as possible. And 007, talking to people may prove helpful. Do so by standing next to them and pressing the A or B button.
Lovely. I think we can figure it out.
Yeah, I only got two buttons. B apparently blocks and A apparently punches. And talks. Medkits replenish lost life.
So did she give you a medkit?
I don't think so. I think I gotta find one.
Oh.
So I searched stuff. This totally looks like a house from Zelda.
Yeah.
Got the bed, the fireplace, an obscure painting.
What about the candles down there in like the lower left? Oh, no. Okay.
And I can't do anything with candles.
Can't start anything on fire?
Ooh, I did find a medkit under the bed.
Nice.
So that's where they keep them. Okay.
So I'm trying to see where on the screen it would show you have a med kit, but I don't see it anywhere.
I think, let's see, inventory.
Oh, there that's right, the inventory.
Yeah, it's in your inventory. And
how did you get to inventory, like select or something?
Yeah, select is inventory, and start is your pause. It's actually has save files, which is kind of surprising for an original Game Boy title. Bridge has been out. So,
I'm really liking this music.
Obviously, I'm going to have to fix a bridge.
You need to...
This would come in handy for a handyman. Ha ha ha.
Fixing bridge?
I got a hammer, so... Have you met my husband? He is the only qualified repairman in this village. Okay, so we have a hammer, a husband, and a broken bridge. Now the question is, which one is her husband? Nah, he's a fisherman.
He's fishing.
Well, yeah, you just move upstream, dude. There's some fish jumping up in by that house. Careful, there are some rough characters around here.
Oh.
I can handle them. I'm Bono. James Bono. That sounds like a Spanish version of James Bond.
Yeah.
If he was Spanish instead of British.
That's awesome.
James Bono. Boathouse.
And instead of drinking the martinis, he'd drink tequila.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Perfect. Well, this is a dead end.
Bummer. There's gotta be... There you go.
Another
there had to have been something in there for it being all the way on the end. Fish. I like how when the fish jump, it makes that noise.
Yeah, these guys are fishing in the exact spots the fish aren't jumping.
If you'd just walk over a little bit.
It was probably too complicated to animate the water, the fishermen, and the fish.
So they put them in different spots.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Can't render the fish and the fishermen on the same screen. That's just too much. Ooh, there's a broken bridge.
Oh, there's a bridge.
Could you please find my hammer? If you do, I can fix this bridge.
Where I found it.
I must have to equip it. Equip hammer. And thwack. Thank you. Come back later. I will have it fixed in no time. At all.
wonder if you just move off the screen and then move back. It'll be done.
Come back. Yep, it's done.
Nice.
Told you would be quick. More fish. Our master's temple is to the north. Okay. Our master Zong Ma Mei something. Is a very beautiful woman. Of course she is.
Bono's gonna get her.
Yeah, it wouldn't be a James Bono game without a beautiful woman. Even a man with your good looks won't be able to charm Zong Ma.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
So the challenge?
He likes hard to get place. Women. What do you say? Maybe to the boathouse. See, military leaders enter, but I don't know where they go.
Well, that's not very helpful.
Either that means there's a secret passage, or they, disappear. So keep heading north. Path to the east leads to the master's temple. I thought they said it was north.
Maybe you just gotta go like northeast now.
I like how I'm just punching the beds.
Yeah.
Link had a sword and he slashed everything. Bond just punches everything.
It's like, I'm mad at everything!
I'm supposed to help my friend move the cart, but I have to fix this flat tire first.
Sucks. I'm glad he didn't ask for help.
Yeah, I'm assuming I can't help him. How do you do? Fine. Your face is transparent. You can see the water. You can see the water textures through his face. Especially his beard, which is white. His beard is supposed to be white, but they actually just made it translucent.
That's awesome. I didn't even notice that.
You are like a fish in the pond. Ha ha. About to get caught. Ha ha.
Sure, right. I like how there's a river and they had to build the walkway over the river. Instead of just walking on the ground.
Yeah. So a block is very useful. Oh, halt, who are you? Bono, James Bono. Guard, I don't believe a Mr. Bono is on the guest list. Unfortunate, but I'm afraid I will let myself in. You will have to get through me first. I thought that was kind of obvious.
That's going to be pretty easy. Good point.
Poof.
You turn into a cube.
You turn into a medical bandage. Okay, dungeon time? See, military leaders enter, but I don't know where they go.
So one of them.
Only the privileged may use this temple to meditate. Oh, I'm not here to meditate. Please be reverent in the temple. Yeah, no offense, guys, but I am not here to meditate, so... Oh, that's a lot of candles.
Don't knock them over.
Unlock the secrets of the temple and you'll find what you seek. Temple has many secrets.
Ooh.
Well, that's delightfully vague.
So the only other way to go is up. What?
Punching Buddha doesn't do anything. Seen the temple, enter this room, but never exit.
Oh, so it's in here somewhere.
Secret passage.
Oh.
I'll find enlightenment in this secret passage. I don't know, this doesn't look like...
A bunch of files.
This doesn't look like enlightenment. It's more like paperwork.
Yeah.
Ooh, is this a safe I see?
Safe.
It's locked. This must be where the plans are kept. No doy.
Oh, now, so there's got to be a key somewhere.
Now to find a way to... Okay. So we got to open the safe. Well, can... I'd better get the plans first. Can't go that way. Come on, doesn't... Where's all those gadgets? Should have one of those safe-cracking gadget.
Yeah. Key's got to be in here somewhere.
Ooh, I wonder what this will open. Gee, I wonder.
Definitely not that safe.
No, of course not. Who would be so stupid as to hide a key to a safe in the same room? Or relatively same room? Fuck, this must be...
Oh, I gotta equip the key. Yeah.
Equip key. Ah, plans. Yeah, welcome, Mr. Bono. I hope you've enjoyed your stay in China. It appears your visa is about to expire. Hint, hint. Thanks for the notice. I'll have to renew it when I'm done here. Okay, so we're apparently not charming this lady. Come on. Does Bond ever hit girls? I mean, is that like a thing he does?
I don't really know. Maybe you just have to run out the room.
Well, we could try. Ow. No spinny top thing. Hey, ouch. Ah. Oh.
That didn't work. Oh, are you kidding me?
Oh, wait. Okay, I do have the secret plans. So I just gotta backtrack all the way through there.
Oh my goodness.
Is it a shortcut? Okay, can't I just get in my speedboat and ditch? Well, that's humiliating. We got defeated by a kung fu lady. Oh, we gotta fight him again? Very simple combat system here.
Yeah. Don't have to think about it too much.
At least these guys, you block, attack, block, attack, block, attack. Nope, can't leave. Okay, if you're gonna spam the spin thing, I'm gonna spam the punch. Good night, darling. I'll see myself out. Nothing interesting here. Oh, okay. Oh. Ah, so it comes out on a different side of the temple.
Cool.
Oh, now I gotta fight my way past all the goons. So this is like Zelda, but without the puzzles and dungeons.
Yeah, in bond music, and women.
Yes.
And just karate chops, I guess, too.
I wonder if you eventually get any gadgets.
Yeah, I wonder how a gun would work. That's really... I really don't see there being too many cool gadgets. Some reason.
You know, I mean, it does have a rather large inventory screen.
That's true, yes.
I suppose it's possible. That would be a rather clumsy way to switch between all your gadgets.
Yeah, it just could be because they, you know, it's easier to take a full screen or whatever.
But the inventory system actually reminds me a lot of Link's Awakening. The same sort of thing, where you have two slots that you can equip, like, just anything to. In this case, it's a block and a punch. I'll just leave you. That is no fair.
Yeah.
Oh, look, fish. They don't get distracted. Oh, come on. You can't just kick me as soon as I enter the screen. Is that all of them? Ah, seriously? Those guys are total campers. Very polite of them to wait their turn.
Yes, it is.
I can't imagine trying to do this combat system with multiple guys attacking me from all sides. That would be a disaster. Okay. Plans appear to be blueprint for a hidden base, although its location is not listed. I'd better get these to M as soon as possible. And there's my speedboat.
London!
Money, Penny Bond, you should not leave until you receive your mission from M. Okay, well.
Pretty cool game.
Yeah, I'm curious to see where it goes from here. The light vest. What does that do?
Bulletproofage? Ooh.
That's weird.
You lose something for it. You lose your punching.
Huh. Yeah, it would be interesting to see how the combat and inventory system work later in the game. Because this definitely has a very Zelda Link's Awakening vibe.
Mm-hmm.
So. Alright, well. Okay, well, should we move on to another game now?
Yeah, as awesome as Bond was, I think we can move on.
Okay, so I need a random letter.
W.
W, how about a number?
3.
Wacky races.
Ooh.
This ought to be good.
Whatever that is. Have you ever heard of it?
No. It's by Infogrames. I've played a few of their games. Warner Brothers, okay. Looney Tunes. I'm thinking. Dastard. Okay, wait. Dastard. What? I have no idea who that is.
That's a pretty rocking car.
Okay, this totally reminds me of 102 Dalmatians for the Game Boy Color. Okay. Okay, so this is a Hanna-Barbera stuff. We got Penelope Pit Stop, Crimson Hay Baler, somebody, the Slag Brothers, oh, they sound nice, Mean Machine, Rufus Rough Cut, I do not know half these people, Turbo Terrific, oh,
really,
here we go,
neat,
the Anthill Mob. Must be the Anthill Mob.
Very cool.
Super. What? Crazy. That's locked.
Fun.
Okay, so
that
I guess
must be easy.
Well, we'll do the fun course.
Okay. 15 kilometers, huh?
In Arkansas? Is that what that said?
Yep.
Racing in 2D, this ought to be good. This totally sounds like a Game Boy Color.
Are the controls easy or no?
And
looks like you're doing a good job.
I would say they're... Oh, gee, I wonder what that sounds like. The ghost power-up? They totally ripped that sound effect from Mario Kart.
Yeah.
Well, so far I'd say this is about as easy as Sonic Drift or any other racing game. Ouch. Any racing game where you're not actually racing in 3D. It's probably a little easier to control than something like Pole Position. Controls aren't quite as sensitive.
Okay.
They totally stole all their power-ups from Mario Kart.
Oh, oil slick.
The oil slick. Turbo. More
turbo.
Right into a bomb. What position am I in? Last?
Well. You, bummer.
Yeah, when you run over a car, it slows you down.
Really?
Yeah, which I'd rather have just bump into the car, I guess. It was probably too hard to process. Missiles. Ah. We're not very good at this.
You're not doing... I mean, you know, you're in second to last place, but you could be doing worse.
Oh, apparently those are homing missiles. That's nice. Okay, I'm running over a robot. Is that a robot?
Robot. Androids belong on phone, not on road.
Yeah.
Oh, another oil slick. Ow.
Boost. Oh, come on. I just activated my super boost.
You're almost done with the lap.
Here we go. Super boost.
Yeah, fourth place, come on, third place, yeah, third place.
See, does that not sound exactly like Mario Kart Ghost?
Exactly like it, yeah.
So Blurry Aviator Dude got first, Blurry Aviator Gal got second, and me, Mr. Top Hat Tom here got third.
Oh, now you're on to Missouri.
Ooh.
This is a pretty neat game.
Yeah, it's not too shabby. I mean, for a two-dimensional racing game.
Yeah. This track is overgrown with grass.
I'd say this is probably actually easier to control than Sonic Drift. Sonic Drift, ironically, was a little too drifty. It was very easy to kind of spin out and oversteer around the corners. Where are these people getting all these bombs? Okay, I have no idea what those did, but I'm in first. Ah, dang. Is it just me, or am I going faster?
It seems like you're going faster.
So under each lap, you must go faster.
Oh.
So I can't say this game is the easiest on the eyes.
No, definitely not.
Especially the road texture is absolutely awful. Okay, what the heck does a W do for me? Oh, invincibility, okay. Man, their system for giving out items is a little wacky.
How so?
It's not very unbalanced. I'm in first place and I'm getting invincibility stars, ghosts, triple missiles. So yeah, it's not quite like Mario Kart where the you get more powerful items the further back you are.
Yeah. Probably have the same chance of getting each item no matter where you are.
Yep.
That was too confusing back in the day.
Okay, should we do Mississippi and then move on?
Sure. One more. Ooh. Different.
This road texture looks halfway decent. Let's see how it looks when we get going really fast. Oh, we got jumps.
Whoa.
And it actually changes. Huh. So why doesn't the ghost power steal power-ups? They're gonna
That was simulating a jump and not water. That's what it looked like the first time I saw it.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was supposed to be water or just supposed to be... That must be water. We're driving through the Mississippi. So we must be taking jumps over water.
Going over the Mississippi River.
Yeah. Soundtrack isn't that bad.
No, it's kind of catchy.
Oh yeah, see, it slows way down when I go through the water. He's just completely ignoring the jumps.
Third place, come on. Second place.
Ooh, he hit a bomb or something.
There's an airplane. First.
Oh, come on. No! Ha ha! Where's the finish line? No, it's just a checkpoint. Still got another lap.
Yeah, you're getting there.
I think the music and I think the game does speed up through each lap.
Yeah, at least the music does, maybe the signifier, yeah. But it does look like you're running faster.
Yeah, especially this track. This so far I think has the best. This track has the best music I've heard so far in this game. Ha! First place.
Good work. That was a fun game. That was really neat.
Yeah, not bad. Especially for a Game Boy Color game. Oh, and that was the end of the circuit.
So is that the Gold Cup?
That was the Fun Cup.
The Fun? Well, okay, so you don't get like gold, bronze, or silver or anything?
Maybe. That might have been a Gold Cup on there. Okay, next random letter.
How about H?
H. How about a number?
5.
Halloween Racer.
Cool. I guess that's fitting.
Yeah, and another racing game and a Halloween game at that. we'll go with That sounds scary. Okay. Spells. Oh, password. Okay, do we want to be a knight riding a flying Tostido chip?
Yes, definitely want to do that.
Scarecrow. A witch.
No, a Tostido chip, yeah.
Okay, knight on a Tostido chip.
Heck yeah.
Championship. Okay. Vulcan. We are totally riding a Tostido chip. Okay. The road textures are a little better.
How's the Tostido chip handle? Pretty good?
A bit floaty. Okay, so that's so you have a break. Huh. That's interesting. Oh, whoa, hello. Okay, so I'm apparently in first place.
Yeah. Did I just see a snail across the middle of the road?
I think so.
Laps are shorter.
Yeah, that was awful fast. I didn't even catch to see who I was competing against.
Can you shoot the stuff you're getting? Because it looked like a spider web.
No, I just have a brake button, apparently. I don't seem to have power-ups.
Tornado?
A snail. All kinds of road obstacles.
Maybe the snail would make you go slower, the tornado spin you out or something.
Collect coins.
Those are just coins, yeah.
Okay, so apparently I won.
Yay! Obviously the Tostido chip is the way to go.
Yeah, every time, we always race a Tostido chip. Okay, hey. No, I wanted the other track. Okay.
You're gonna have to do this first one over.
See, there's two other races up there that I can do, but it won't let me select them. It'll only let me do this one. Okay, I don't quite get their menu system here. Halloween rookie race, one of eight. So do I have to do eight races on that one course?
I don't know. You think it'd be like eight different tracks, but...
Yeah. Huh. I don't know, I don't feel like racing on that same course again.
Yeah.
Wacky racers or crazy racers or whatever was better. Okay. Next letter.
E.
E. And how about a number?
Two.
That would be... I'm skipping down one because there's two versions. One was European, one is US. But that would be E.T. Ooh. Escape from Planet Earth.
Nice.
I sure hope this is better than the 2600 version.
Oh my god. Yeah. Please don't be bad, please.
Okay. Enter name.
Oh, stupid creepy finger. Of course it has to be right there.
That does look creepy. No, that's not what I wanted. Okay.
Oh, E.T.'s landing.
This isn't looking promising.
Looks pretty bad. Oh, look at E.T. Oh my goodness.
He at least looks better than the 2600 version.
He's waddling. Oh, the flower. There's a flower.
Okay. Okay, now here's the white suit guys. Those are some big guns. Oh, they just scared the UFO away?
They didn't shoot at it, at least it didn't look like it. Oh, E.T.
Oh, so obviously we're skipping quite a bit here.
Oh yeah, he's touching Elliot.
Okay.
Yes, do we get to ride with E.T. in the air? Oh.
Okay, so we can jump.
Okay.
What?
That was weird. What? You're in a maze of some sort.
What happened? I'm confused. What? What? I am totally confused. I hit something and then I have to do a maze. Use free... What? Freeze power? What freeze power? That freeze power. Okay. Oh, is this a tutorial? I'll bet you this is the tutorial.
I'm really confused, yeah.
Oops. Okay, that is a very confusing way to go about doing the tutorial.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try to get out of here. What happened? How do we leave? Come on, I wanna leave. Oh, here we go. All three bottle caps come back when you have them. Okay, side quest? What? I already did this. This is totally confusing. Press turn down. Either we have to read the manual or this is as bad as the 2600 version. Wait, okay, I am totally lost. Oh, okay, that we completed that one. Maybe now we can leave.
Have you ever played a good ET game?
I the only ET game I've played is the 2600 one. So
no good ET games.
Yeah. Oh wait, were those the bottle caps you wanted? Good, okay. Press the B. Oh, so now we can fly. Or maybe we can fly before. Go to the city. Yes, yes, get out of here.
You figured something else? Yeah.
Need a battery.
Whoa, E.T.!
So you touch those weird things. Okay, so this is a puzzle, okay. So you touch those weird glowy things, and that gives you to a maze that you have to navigate E.T. around.
That is weird.
Yeah. Huh. Okay, so maybe slightly better than the 2600 version.
E.T. can heal a human being, but he can't,
he can't heal himself. Ah! Come on, can't you move faster than that? Try this one more time. Okay. Ah. Can't say much for the city.
Yeah, I don't know about this game.
Yeah. Ooh, I landed on top of a house. So we basically just ride around. What's this? Use what?
It's a toxic waste.
Okay.
What is that stuff?
That. Sure don't give you much for directions.
No.
Oh, use Elliot. Oh, okay. Well, come on, dude. It's a weird puzzle game. Yeah, this is just a puzzle game thinly wrapped in an adventure-ish. Game. Very thinly. That actually would probably be more interesting if they just wouldn't do that little overworld thing and just have these little puzzles.
Yeah. It is quite the interesting game, that's for sure.
Yeah, because I wouldn't mind doing these little puzzle things. They're sort of neat. But trying to wrap them in that weird overworld map, that's completely confusing to navigate. Exactly, am I getting?
I'm not really sure what the point of this game is.
It's that battery thing, I'll bet. How do I get to it? Maybe he can move stuff. Maybe ET can't move barrels. Oh, right, I can jump over things. So I can... Wait. Did I just use that ice thing on the wrong spot?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. Alright, we'll do one more game. I don't want to retry that. Okay. Random letter.
T.
Oops. Okay. T. Random number.
4.
T to the arcade game. Is that Terminator 2?
That's what I think.
Let us see. T 2. Midway. Elgin. Beam software. Oh, yep, Terminator.
Cool.
3 billion human lives ended, whether survivors or the fire. I'm assuming this has something to do with the Terminator movie. Oh wow. They aren't kidding when they said this is the arcade game.
Are you just shooting?
Yes.
That's okay.
I'm the crosshair, I'm moving the crosshair, and I'm shooting. They aren't kidding when they said this is an arcade game. This is something that is...
That's interesting.
Ah! Apparently something that is supposed to be played with a light gun.
Does this sound that annoying on your end, too?
Kinda, yeah. These good guys, or... Who are these guys? Hello, what happened?
Oh, faster gun.
Oh. I think it slows down as I run out of ammo. Or something. I don't know.
Oh, the bar there down on the bottom.
There's an energy bar and there's a gun bar? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Okay, I have no idea who are on my side and who are on their side. Is that missiles? They get missiles. Oh, that. Ooh, destructible environments.
Wow.
Kinda. Yeah, I'm not seeing this as being a very fun game on the Game Boy.
Yeah, if this is it, I mean, that gets old pretty fast.
Yeah, especially the noise, the sound effects are awful.
Oh, this must be the standoff
boss. So are those my guys? I think. I can shoot them. I don't know if that means anything. Oh, miss. Man, it's hard to aim with a D-pad.
Yeah, I bet.
Oh, what do we have here? A tank thing. Whoa, 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 wait, wait. Hello. Is that... that thing shooting at me?
Oh yeah, it's shooting at you.
I just see puffballs. Okay, that was like no fair.
Take out his guns.
Oh, ow.
No.
I don't seem to be damaging anything. I'm like, oh wait, I got his head. Ah, it's still shooting at me. Oh, there, I took out one gun.
It is the guns, okay.
And I died.
Man, the machines, jeez, they took over the world fast.
Yeah, the...
Resistance.
Okay, well...
Can't that say was much. Lovely.
Can't say much for that game.
Yeah.
E.T. was better than that.
Yeah, E.T. was.
Yeah.
That at least, once you got out of the overworld and into the puzzles, the puzzles were bad.
Yeah, they were. But I didn't really understand why those were in there.
Yeah. Well, I think that'll do it for this interesting episode of In Retrospection. So if you want to read more retro reviews and find more episodes, even some of the regular random retro bonus round shows, you can find that on my blog at retrogamesforever.com or follow me on Twitter at JoshuaCaleb75. And Dustin, you can be found on Twitter and everywhere.
Yep. SCHMIDTDA Schmidt Duh on Twitter. Kind of weird, I know. But and then Google Plus as well. You can just search for my name, Dustin Schmidt. You can find me.
All right, cool. Well, that does it for this week. And for next week, we'll be back.